Everybody, today we are going to discuss about experiment number 6, that is BCT to gray code converter. Let's move on to that. So what is our aim of the experiment here? It is design and implement a BCT to gray code converter. So we need to design and we need to implement of a BCT to gray code converter. First we need to understand what is the meaning of BCT and how we are going to convert to gray code, and later looking for the circuit diagram of that and implementation part. You can see that how to do the BCD to gray code conversion. So you already know that BCD are nothing but here it is 0 to 9. So we're having the binary numbers like B0, B1, B2, B3. So here I'm going to take one value, here it is 0011. So how it is converting, this is a XOR operation of the bits. For example, first bit you need to take, means this one B3 bit you need to consider as it is. Next, this bit XOR with this one. 0 XOR with 0, I'll get the next bit, this is 0. Next, 0 XOR with 1, I'll get it is 1. 1 XOR with 1, I'll get 0. So now, so here this is B3, B2, B1, B0 are my binary numbers. And G3, G2, G1, G0 are my gray code. So in this way, just doing the XOR operation of the bits, easily we can convert any binary number into its gray code. Then how to write the equation? You can see that G3, it is directly coming to the B3. Then we are going to take as a G3 is equal to B3. Next, so G2 is nothing but what? So XOR operation of B3 and B2. You can see that B3 XOR with B2. Similarly, G1, this bit I am going to take, and G1 is nothing but XOR operation of B2 and B1. B2 and B1. Next, G0 is nothing but XOR operation of B1 XOR with B0, we are going to take on B1 XOR with B0. So these are the gray code equations, what it's coming from the binary. Okay, then how to write the circuit diagram? We can see that here it is. So G3 is equal to B3, means B3 directly can connect with the G3 now. So just do the XOR operation. So based on this circuit diagram, based on this equation, easily we can write the circuit diagram. But here it is our main intention, it is we need to implement this one using our NAND gates. Let's take the NAND gate now. So before going to that, I'll take the all the values from here. It is BCD is nothing but 0 to 9. First I'm going to take on a BCD value, here it is 0002, here it is 9 I'm going to take on. So 0001 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. If it is a binary to gray code, means we need to take from 0002 maximum value, it is 1111, up to 11 we need to consider. That is a small difference, remaining thing it is same thing only. Okay, let's move on to that. So I already told that G3 is nothing but XOR operation of these bits. So B3 is nothing but, according to this one, G3 is equal to B3. Directly you can take it out, here it is my B3 value, whatever the value you have, 0000 11 here. So finally you have the value, it is G3, as it is you need to write. Next, G2 is nothing but XOR operation of these two. 0 XOR with 0, I'll get 0. 0 XOR with 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, next 0, 1. So these four cases, it is 1, 1 only I'll get. Next, it is 1, 0 means I'll get it is 1, 1 only. Next, do the XOR operation of these two. And similarly, you do this XOR operation of these two, I'll get the values of G1 and G0. You just check it out and do the XOR operations. Okay. Once you did this value, once you got the table, then next we need to verify this table and implementing using NAND gate implementation. So in order to do this process, so just I'm going to convert it, this one to NAND gate operation. You can see that G3 is equal to B3, not an issue. G2, what I'm getting it is B3 XOR with B2. So XOR operation is nothing but, you know that A XOR of B is nothing but A bar B plus A B bar. Similarly, B3 XOR with B2 is nothing but B3 bar B2 plus B3 B2 bar. And we are going to take it as a double bar for that. If you take the double bar, not an issue, these two get cancelled. So I'm going to take a double bar. Because of this bar, I'm going to split it into parts. You can see how I'm going to split it. This one, so this dot become, plus become here, it is dot. You can see here. And next you'll get the bar, it will come to for P3 bar and B2 and P3 bar and B2 bar. So next bar also already is there. So for this one, it is a NAND gate, one NAND gate. For this one also, you'll get the another NAND gate. B through B2 bar, it will get the NAND gates. Similarly, you can try for G1 and G0. So same thing, because instead of B3, B2, you have B2 and B1 and B1 and B0. same equation only you are getting. So instead of 3, 2, what is the value again? 2, 1 and 1, 0. Okay. Then how to implement using NAND gate? You can just check it out. These are the equations. This is my circuit diagram, what I am trying to tell here. You take B3, B2, B1, B0. Okay. Once you take B3, B2, B1, B0, if you want NOT gate, you already know how to write a NOT gate from the NAND gate. So it's a conversion. So this is a NOT gate representation in terms of NAND. You just write the, we need to short the both the inputs and you can connect it to here. So here I'll get the B3 and bar and B2 bar, and here it is B1 bar and B0 bar. Once it is coming all the values, then you can connect according to this equation. You can see that G3 is equal to B3. So my G3 value directly you can short to my B3. Second case, you can see here it is. So what I'm getting here, it is B3 bar and B2. It is connected to bar. It's nothing but AND gate, NAND gate. We need to connect the one NAND gate. Finally, this is also one NAND gate. And after connecting these two, so finally these two we need to connect to the one more NAND gate. So first I'll connect to B3 bar and B2. You can see here it is. So B3 bar, this is a B3 bar you have, and you have a B2. It is connected to one AND gate. Next it is B3 and B2 bar. We are going to connect to another AND gate. These two we are going to connect it to the one more NAND gate. So this is my G2. Similarly, you just connect the connections based on the equations. You can see here it is. These are my equations what we are getting. So just do the connections based on this equation. This is the circuit diagram of that. Once you got this, next you already know the pin diagram of your IC, NAND gate IC. Based on that, we can select that. So what are the IC it is coming, here it is, and how we are going to do that. So we can do the connections. Okay. You can see here it is. This is my IC what we are going to use, IC7400. This is my IC what we are going to use. Okay. Yeah. You can use IC7400. So you can connect here the pins. So pin, it's very important. So here it is. I can see here how many gates it is there. Here it is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Totally we have a 13 gates. But from one IC it is possible only 4 gates. So then how many gate it is required? At least if you choose 3 gates, 3 cross 4 is nothing but I'll get the 12 gates. Okay. Then I need to use at least 3. So you can see that. So 1, 2, 3, 4 I can use extra. So here it is better thing. You can use anyway. I require 3, it is not possible. 4 I need to use at least. Then used one IC for this. Okay, so this is the second gate you can use for this. So third, another IC used for this, and another IC you can use for this case. Okay, let's do these connections. Based on that you can do the operations. Let's move on to how to connect this one in IC simulator. So just see the pin diagram. So 1 and 2 are input, 3 it is the output, same thing, 4, 5 input, 6 is the output, 8 it is the output, 9 and 10 are my inputs, 11 it is the output, 12 and 13 it is the output. This is from the one IC. Used one IC for this, another IC for this, another IC for this, and another IC for this. Later we can do the connection from this part. Okay, let's move on to the connections. Okay, I'm going to use DeltaSim simulator for this connection. You can see the circuit diagram. What we have, this is a 7400. I need to do the connection. First, you need to choose how many gates. 1, 2, 3, 4 gates it's required. Just select the IC7400, 4 slots. How to do? Add IC, select the slot. So 7400. You can go down and just check it out. Where is my IC7400? Yeah, here only is there IC7400. It is a NAND gate IC. Just select this and give add IC. Similarly, how many gates? 4 gates it's required for me. Just do add IC, select this base, NAND gate, add IC. Similarly, add IC, select this, NAND gate, add IC. Similarly, add IC, select this NAND gate, add IC. Once you did these connections, next, what is the main task? I already told that we need to connect to VCC and ground. 7400, it's a 14 pin IC. So we already know that. So 14, it is my VCC. Just I'm going to connect it to the VCC for all the pins. So here, this is my 14th pin. I'm going to connect to VCC. This one also, it is connected to VCC. And this one also, I'm going to connect it to the VCC. Okay. So make sure that all we need to connect to VCC as well as ground. Pin number 7, I need to connect to the ground. And here it is pin number 7, you need to connect to the ground. Pin number 7, you need to connect to the ground. Okay, here also pin number 7, it is connected to the ground. Okay, let's move on to the first circuit. What I'm going to do here, it is, that's very important. So here you can see that first gate, you can see that B3, B2, B1, B0 you have. First, what I am doing here, it is 1 and 2, I need to short and you need to connect it to the B3. So similarly, 4 and 5, I need to connect it to here. So first IC I am taken here, you can see that 1 and 2, 4, 5. So you have a 1 and 2, where I need to connect it to the B3. So this is my B3, I am going to take one of the input. Let's take the, this one, it is my B3, 1. And you need to connect it to, this is my B3. Okay. These three, it is the output. Similarly, AND gate, 4 and 5, you need to connect it to the B2. 4, you can see that. This is my B2, 4, and 5. You need to connect it here only. 4 and 5, I connect it to the B2. Next, you can see here, from the circuit 1 and 2, 3 it is output. Leave this one, later I'm going to use that. 4 and 5, 6 it is the output. Next, 8 it is the output. 9 and 10 are my inputs. I can use this 9 and 10. So 7, 8 is there, 9. So 9 and 10. It should be connected to B1. Now this is B3, this is B2, and this is B1. Okay, now what is the next pin? Just check it out. 12, 13 and 11. 12, 13. You can see that. Sorry, this one it is connected already. Because 8 it is output, 9 and 10 are inputs. Now this is the output, then these two I can connect it to the inputs. This one. This one. Okay. Take care about this connection. Suppose if it is not connected, means then it is a problem. So remember, I am not connected outputs 3, 5, 6, 7, it is connected to the ground. Next it is 8, it's output, and 9 I am not connected still now. These are my outputs. This is the first IC. So I already told that. So this is the first IC, now it is over. Next, I'll go for the second IC connection. Second IC connection, okay. So I'll just do the connection for this one, later I can do that. So this combination, I'll do that one later part. You can see that. Yeah. So here it is, 3 to 9, you need to short. 3 to 9, 6 to 10. Let's move on to that. Second IC, 3 to 9. Second high C, 3 to 9. Where is 9? So you can see that 7, 8, 9. So see 3 to 7, 8, 9. I did that. Similarly, next 6 to 10 you can connect. 6 to 10. 6 is there. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You can connect it here. Carefully, you need to connect. Yes, 6 to 10 I connected. Next connection. 6 to 10. Next, here it is. You need to do the same thing for the remaining 3 ICs also. 3 to 9, 6 to 10. This process. 3 to 9. means 7, 8, 9. You need to connect to the 15. Yes, 3 to 9, and 6 to. Ten. You can see that 3 to 9, 6 to 10. Okay. Similarly, for another connection, 3 to 9, 7, 8, 9. Okay, 6 to 6 to. You can connect it to the 10. Now I did this connection. Mid connection. Now this part I'm going to give it to this G3, G2, G1, G0. You can see that G3 value, these are my outputs. B is my inputs, G it is my output. Then I can connect B3 directly to G3. How to do this? So this one I taken a B3, you can connect it to the G3. This output section. So I can connect B3 directly to the G3. You can do this connection. Or next. Okay, you can see that G2, it is connected to the first IC pin number 8 8 8 8. It is G2 G1 G0. So what I am doing, where is my pin number 8? 7 it is there, 8 you connect it here. This is my G2. Next, this is my G1, and this is my 8th pin, it is G0. Output sections. Okay, now you can see that G3, G2, G1, G0 are output. Here it is, you can see that B3, B2, B1, B0 are my inputs. Once you got this, next thing here it is, go to circuit. Now what I did, I completed this portion and this portion. Now I need to connect it this one. Okay, now you can see that what are the pins. Pin number 3 of first IC, it is connected to the 1. That's very important. Okay, just the first IC, first AND gate, you can see that 3 to 1. So here it is, 3 is there, output, you connect it to the 1. Next, this 3 you connect it to the 1. Next, B2 you need to connect it to the 2. B2, this is my B2, you can connect it to the 2. Careful about this, the connections. You need to connect B2 to 2. Next. So once it is over, now I completed this connection. Next, move on to this connection. B3 you need to connect it to the 4, and 6 you need to connect it to the 5. B3 you need to connect it to the 4. Where is my B3? Yeah, B3 is there. You need to connect it to the 4. Yes, I connected. Next. Next, what you need to do? B3 you connect it to the 4, and 6 you need to connect it to the 5. Pin number 6. This is my 6. You need to connect it to the 5. 6 you need to connect to the 5. So once you did this connection, now you can see that I finished this part. This one already connected, right? Then it is over. Let's move on to this one. So this connection, you can see that 6 you need to connect it to the 1, and B1 you need to connect to the 2. Okay, first I'll do the 6 to 1 of second IC. 6 to 1. You can see, always I'm talking about the first IC, 6 to 1. Yeah, where is my 6? 6 to 1. Okay. 6 to 1 I connected. Next. This connection. B1 to 2. Where is my B1? Yeah, this is my B1. Here to 2. You need to connect it here. Next. Okay, So B1 to 2, I'm going to connect it. Next, I'll go for this case, B2 to 4. Okay, this is my B2. You connect it here to 4. Okay, next. B2 to 4, and I can connect pin number 8 to 5. Just remember, 8 to 5. Where is my 8? 7 and 8. This 8, you need to connect it to the 5. Okay. So, it's over, I think. 8 to 5. We already connected. This connection, this G1 also over. Next, I'll go for G0. It's very simple. Again, 8 to 1. Again, this 8 to 1. Carefully, you need to connect. Sometime it is not connected means you need to reconnect. Yeah, it is connected. Okay. Next. What is it? B0. B0 to 2. 2. Where is my B0? Yeah, B0. From here to 2, you can connect. Yeah, this one over. Next, I'll go for this B1 to 4. B1 to 4. You can connect B1 to 4. Yes. B1 to 4. And B0 to 5. Nothing but, sorry, B0 bar is nothing but pin number 11. You can see it is 11. 11 to 5. 11. Where is my 11? 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yeah. This one to 5. Okay. So 11 to 5. So, right, 11 to 5. Yeah, now it is over. So, I think we did all connections. Now, let's check it out the output. We connected. Yeah, just I'll go switch on my trainer kit. Now, what is the values it's required? How to verify? Let's go to the truth table of my binary to gray code. You can see if it is 0000, I'll get 0000. Yeah, we're getting it is 00. P3, B2, B1, B0 are 00. Then what is the value you're getting? 0000. Now, what I'm doing here it is, I'll change the values. 001. So 001, what is the value you're getting here it is? So you can see that 0001. Is it correct? Just check it out. 001, 001. Now I'll give 0010, I'll get. 0010. I'll give 001 and I'll make it as a 0. 0010. B3, B2, B1, B0, 10010, what is the value getting? 001 and 1. Just verify that. Yes, 0010, it is nothing but 0011, what you are getting. Next, you can see here it is, 0010011. Yeah. Next combination, 0011, it is nothing but 0010. Yeah, 0011 is nothing but 0010 we are getting. Similarly, you check for any other conditions. Okay, I'll take this one. 1000, I'll check. 1100, I need to get. 1 followed by all zeros. 1 followed by, okay. 1 followed by zeros. Next, what is the value we're getting? 1100, you can see that. 1011100 we're getting. Yes, next 10001 means we are getting 10001 means I'm getting 1101. You can check it out. Similarly, you just check for any other conditions, it's coming. So this is the conversion of my binary code to BCD to gray code converter. Okay, thank you.